had felt a lump and had no insurance at the time and knew that I needed to get a mammogram. And there was a few places that I tried with no success. And Norwalk Hospital had a program, free mammogram program that was funded by Pink Aid. And I had my mammogram, and from there, I was diagnosed.
The last thing we need to worry about are our finances, but that's a huge piece of what we're worrying about. So what a wonderful offering by Pink Aid to help.
When I was in chemotherapy and I looked around the room, I couldn't help but wonder and worry about the women that were sitting next to me that might not have had a ride to and from chemotherapy, a home-cooked meal when they went home, chocolate chip cookies, friends, family, a community behind them to support them. And the thought of that was daunting, and all we want is for them and all these women to have the same opportunity that we had, to have support services and to have people around them that care about them with compassion and to be able to give them everything that I was able to receive. We needed to pay it forward, and we needed to make sure that all women had the same opportunity.
In 5 short years, Pink Aid has funded 18 organizations and has become an invaluable and relied upon resource throughout Connecticut. Pink Aid grants support a growing list of diagnostic and compassionate services, including help with rent and utilities, food cards, transportation, mastectomy bras and recovery garments, education, wellness, and psychological counseling. It sits really
nice in the back. Me gustaría agradecer a Pink Aid por todo el support que da a Cancer Care para llegar a todos los lugares latinos con nuestros talleres acerca de la prevención del cáncer del seno.
And in 2015, Pink Aid's Pink Purse was launched to provide emergency aid to breast cancer patients.
Pink Purse helped pay my rent for 1 month. That made me feel stress-free for my treatments. I feel much better after that.
They helped me renew my OT license, which has to be renewed every year. And they also helped pay an electric bill. This is at a time where, you know, I'm not working, so it's a lot harder. It's just a little tighter. Everything's a little tighter. So every little bit helps.
In just 5 years, Pink Aid fever has spread like wildfire. From high schools playing for Pink to fundraisers like Band Together and Sweat for Pink. Pink Aid fever got so hot it even crossed the Sound. Pink Aid Long Island is going strong, raising $240,000 in its first year and making 6 grants across Long Island.
We have a fashion show that's on par to what you'll see in Paris, Milan, any fashion week around the world. But we wanted to add a second fashion show that we call the Warrior Show. There, we close out our event with between 10 and 15 women walking the runway who are survivors of breast cancer with someone who supported them.
Walking down that runway with my dearest friend in the world and my mother-in-law really brought home the joy of the success and the joy of defeating cancer.
These people, these strangers who are your cheering squad, they're literally cheering and whistling and clapping, and everybody's applauding your rebirth.
This wasn't about what you're wearing. It wasn't about the fashion. It was about healing. It's about moving forward. So as much as Pink Aid helps the patient, it also helps the survivors.
Being surrounded by the women that were cheering me on, sending out love, sending out compassion, women that I know care so passionately about helping others and inspiring and encouraging, that to me was just an incredible experience. I want to do it again.
Came in like the breeze, I felt it in my knees. Never will it leave, each day it is retrieved. See? feels like yesterday. Your eyes crave this way.